So since we have here in physical layer, that's not good. Since we have compute network and storage subsystems, right? And if our objective is to create this data center that is completely logical and defined in software, we do need to virtualize compute subsystem, for example, using vSphere technology, right? We do need to virtualize networking subsystem, for example, using NSX technology. And we do need to virtualize our storage subsystem, right? Using vSAN and or vVol technology, right? That's gonna give us three pools of virtualized resources to create logical computers defined in software, logical networks defined in software, logical storages defined in software, and these three logical constructs are gonna constitute what? Software defined data center that is completely decoupled from this physical underlay. Think about this logical data center that is completely decoupled from this physical underlay. I don't know. For now, it's running on this building's premises, on this data center's premises. And the moment after, it's gonna be live migrated to a remote data center. So, because it's decoupled, all its parts, right? All its subsystems are defined in software. The pure magic. But again, we are focusing on this part now, right? And we assume that we have done with compute virtualization, right? At least we have this general understanding of storage virtualization, right? We last week we've introduced vSAN and vVol, right? As a way to virtualize your storage subsystem and create logical storages defined in software, software-defined storage, right? Okay.